cosine of 2 theta is equal to c, and theta is between 0 and pi. Write a formula for sine of theta in terms of c. And so I encourage you to pause the video and try to figure this out on your own before I work through it. So I'm assuming you've had a go, so let's see if we can work through it together. And I'm going to get my scratch pad out. I copied and pasted the exact question right over here. And so let's think about it a little bit. They're telling us that cosine of 2 theta is equal to c. So let me write it this way. C is equal to cosine of 2 theta. Now, using my knowledge of angle addition formulas, we know, for example, that cosine of alpha plus beta, we know that cosine of alpha plus beta is equal to cosine alpha is equal to cosine alpha cosine beta minus sine alpha sine beta minus sine alpha sine beta. Now, why would this be useful here? Well, this is the sum of just theta plus theta. And so I can rewrite this, at least in terms of cosines and sines, and maybe I can rewrite the cosines in terms of sines, and then solve for the sines. So let's try to do that. So I can rewrite cosine of 2 theta. That's the same thing as cosine of theta plus theta. Cosine of theta plus theta is, of course, the same thing as 2 theta. And now I can use the angle addition formula for cosine. This is going to be equal to cosine of theta times cosine of theta minus sine of theta times sine of theta times sine of theta, which is of course equal to, this is equal to cosine squared theta. That's equal to cosine squared theta minus, and what we have right over here is sine squared theta. So let's see, we've been able to rewrite c in terms of cosine squared theta and sine squared theta, but ideally we just want to write it in terms of sine theta so that we can solve for sine theta. So if we can re-express cosine theta in terms of sine, well, we already know from the Pythagorean identity that cosine squared theta plus sine squared theta is equal to 1, or we could say that cosine squared theta is equal to, I'm just going to subtract sine squared from both sides, is equal to 1 minus sine squared theta. So let me rewrite this as 1 minus sine squared theta, and then of course we have minus this yellow sine squared theta, and all of this is equal to c. Or we could get that c is equal to 1 minus 2 sine squared theta. And what's useful about this is now we just have to solve for sine of theta. So let's see. I could multiply both sides by a negative just so that I can switch the order over here. So I could write this as negative c is equal to 2 sine squared theta. 2 sine squared theta minus 1. I just multiplied both sides by a negative. And then, let's see, I could add 1 to both sides. If I add 1 to both sides, and I'll go over here. If I add 1 to both sides, I get 1 minus c. 1 minus c is equal to 2 sine squared theta. 2 sine squared theta. I can divide both sides by 2. And then, so I get sine squared theta is equal to 1 minus c over 2. Or I could write that sine of theta is equal to the plus or minus square root of 1 minus c over 2. So that leads to a question. Is it both? Is it the plus and minus square root, or is it just one of those? And I encourage you to pause the video again in case you haven't already figured it out, and look at the information here, and think about whether they give us the information of whether we should be looking at the positive or negative sign. Well, they tell us that theta is between 0 and pi. So if I were to draw a unit circle here, between 0 and pi radians. So at this angle right over here is 0 radians, and pi is going all the way over here. Pi is going all the way over here. So this angle places its terminal, I guess its terminal ray, either in the first or second quadrants. So it could be an angle like this, it could be an angle like this, it cannot be an angle like this. And we know that the sine of an angle, is the y coordinate. And so we know if we're in the first or second quadrant, the y coordinate is going to be non-negative. So what we would want to take the positive square root right over here. So we would get sine of theta is equal to the principal root, or you could even think of it the positive square root, of 1 minus c over 2. So let's go back to our, make sure that we can, let's check our answer. So sine of theta is equal to the square root of 1 minus capital C, all of that over 2, and we got it right.